Sudan receives more aid to cope with unprecedented rainfall. Through its Agency for International Development, USAID, the United States has gifted an additional $60 million US to help the country recover from severe flooding. This comes on the heels of $81 million US in general assistance given to Sudan after it joined the US brokered peace agreement with Israel. Israel is a Shining World Leadership Award for Peace laureate, and Sudan is a Shining World Leadership Awards for Peace and Good Governance laureate. Together with non-profit organizations and international partners, USAID is supporting impacted communities with food, safe drinking water, shelter, sanitation, and hygiene supplies. The United States, a Shining World Leadership Award for Compassion laureate, provided a total of about $500 million US to Sudan in the fiscal year 2020 for relief from multiple disasters, including a low-cost outbreak and the COVID-19 pandemic. Our heartfelt accolades, United States, for your generosity and peace leadership. We pray for the safety and well-being of the Sunni Sudanese people and the comforting love of Allah.
Research reveals extra benefits of wearing face masks. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, or CDC, in the US recently updated its guidance on reducing the spread of COVID-19. The primary reason for covering one's nose and mouth is to block the emission of water droplets that may be carrying the virus. But the filtering works both ways, and individuals wearing masks are protected from inhaling droplets emitted by others. The agency recommends multiple-layer cloth coverings made from material with a high thread count. Experiments have shown that such masks are more than 80% effective, and if more people wore them, lockdowns would not be needed and economic losses would be drastically reduced. We are grateful, CDC, for your diligent work and important recommendations. May all people fulfill their duty to protect themselves and others in divine wisdom.
Baltic drivers are exchanging four wheels for two. In Lithuania, the Environmental Projects Management Agency, or EPVA, is offering subsidies to citizens who surrender their old automobiles and want to buy eco-friendly alternatives. The public may submit applications for electric scooters, motorcycles, mopeds, bicycles, electric bicycles, or tickets to ride public transport and receive up to 1,000 euros. Upon request, APVA will even consider contributing to the purchase of electric cars. For used vehicles, buyers may be granted 2,000 euros, while purchasers of new models may get 4,000 euros. The first 5 months of the program were so successful that the Minister of Environment allocated an additional 3 million euros to keep it going. We applaud your creative strategy, Lithuania, for motivating your population to embrace more sustainable mobility. As the air quality improves, so does your country's quality of life and celestial delight.
Physicists translate infrared radiation into visible light inexpensively. The human eye is limited to detecting photons at wavelengths between 400 and 700 nanometers, or in other words, between blue and red. However, many materials have a unique color signature at wavelengths above 700 nanometers. Existing conversion equipment to make these colors visible is costly and unavailable for general use. Now, researchers at Tel Aviv University in Israel have invented an affordable device that can be attached to a normal camera and will shift incoming infrared energy to the visible spectrum. This will be useful in medicine. For example, by enabling doctors to find cancer cells, the technology could also be adapted for satellites to be able to spot terrestrial sources of air pollution. What a remarkable achievement, Tel Aviv University scientists! We gratefully anticipate a wide variety of applications for your work in the radiance of the providence.
Homeless people receive protection from winter weather. In Toronto, Canada, the demand for shelter spaces always goes up when the temperature drops. But this year, there are even fewer spots available due to social distancing requirements. Halil Sevrai, a young carpenter, was inspired to do something for the many individuals he saw staying in tents. So he started building tiny mobile homes on casters with fiberglass insulation in the walls, ceiling, and floor. Each structure costs about $780 in materials and 8 hours of Halil's time. Thanks to a GoFundMe page he set up, the Good Samaritan has raised more than $150,000 for the project and delivered shelters to delighted community members around the city. Heaven bless you, Halil Sevrai, for helping those in need with your outer talent and inner goodness. May vulnerable populations everywhere be shielded in divine mercy.
Alternative Meat Company partners with well-known eateries. The popular Chinese restaurant franchisor Dikos has added plant-based chicken burgers and nuggets to its menu. The new options are being supplied by China-based Starfield, and people who have tried them say they have the same flavor and texture as actual chicken. This is the first large-scale collaboration between a domestic developer of meatless proteins and a Chinese fast food chain. The vegan dishes are available at almost all of Dickos' 2,600 Chinese locations and may be ordered through online delivery platforms such as Meituan and Alama. Way to go, Dickos and Starfield, on your joint venture to satisfy Chinese consumers' growing appetite for healthier and more sustainable food. We pray that our world will soon reach world vegan, world peace in heavenly upliftment.
Geneticists discovered that dogs were domesticated before any other animal. An international team of researchers led by the Francis Crick Institute in the United Kingdom has analyzed ancient DNA from the remains of 27 canines. Although it is undetermined when dogs diverged from an extinct wolf population, the scientists know that by the end of the last ice age, most of the diversity we see in our four-legged friends today was already present. In fact, there used to be even more variety among pooches, but this was lost to a great extent over the millennia. A few breeds, like the Chihuahua of Mexico and Rhodesian Ridgeback of southern Africa, still retain some genetic traces from ancestors that were indigenous to those areas. We appreciate your outstanding work, Francis Crick Institute and international researchers. Knowing more about our beloved furry companions heightens our gratitude and unconditional love and blessings.